Hello, anatomy friends. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to Station 15, where we are going to talk through some of the vertebral structures that are common to almost all of the movable vertebrae. So this will not be the video where we're talking about how you can tell the difference between, say, the cervical or the thoracic. These are more structures that you can see in all of these. So we're looking at a thoracic vertebrae here, but that doesn't matter because these structures can be found in the other ones as well. And I always like to start with the body of the vertebra. It can differ in terms of kind of shape and size, but they're always going to be the most anteriorly placed structure. We're looking at a superior view here. So the body will always be anteriorly placed. And then we will have the rest of the vertebrae, which is referred to as the vertebral arch. And we'll talk about the specific parts of the vertebral arch in a moment. But the space in between the vertebral arch and the body is going to be the vertebral foramen, which allows for the transmission, or it will protect that spinal cord and some of its associated structures like the meninges. So the parts of the vertebral arch are going to be these small kind of foot-like petals, which are your pedicles. So these will be kind of that connection between the body and the rest of the vertebral arch. This flattened portion of the arch will be the laminae. And that's exactly what they mean. They are going to be these flattened portions. If you're doing a laminectomy to get to the spinal cord, you would cut through these areas to be able to reflect off the more posterior portions of the vertebrae. And then what else we're going to have you identify are processes. And these processes are important in terms of muscle attachments. In the thoracic region specifically, you'll also have ribs attaching here. So you'll have two lateral projections or processes, and these are the transverse processes. And then the most posterior projection will be the spinous process. And so those are the ones that if you palpate down the middle of your back, you are feeling these spinous processes all the way down. Okay. Now, moving into a lateral view here, this is actually of a lumbar vertebrae, but again, it doesn't really matter which level we're at because all are going to have these. And you'll have these kind of notches between the body and some of these portions of these projections here. You will have a superior articular notch and an inferior articular notch. And that superior articular notch will kind of meet up with the inferior articular notch of the vertebrae above, and kind of the same thing here. And when we put those two together, you are going to form these intervertebral foramina that you can see running down the full length of the vertebral column. You can see these right here. So these are just notches that are meeting up to form these intervertebral foramina, and these are particularly important in terms of allowing the exit of spinal nerves, and so that will allow for those peripheral nerves to be able to head to whatever target organ they are trying to reach. Okay, so those are the basic structures that you will see in almost all movable vertebrae. We will move on in terms of stations, talking a little bit about curvatures as well as how to tell the difference between those vertebrae. Please make sure to reach out if you have any questions, and thank you for your time and attention here.